To find the electronic COSHH system, enter safety into the search engine on the university's main webpage. You will then click on the link to the Occupational Health, Safety and Wellbeing website, followed by Documentation, then click on Forms, and scroll down till you find the S21 form, and click on Online COSHH Form, which takes you to the electronic COSHH login page. Alternatively, you can use the web address www.cosh.strath.ac.uk. This will take you to the electronic COSHH system login page, where you will use your DS login and password to access your account. Here we're using a test account. This will take you to the members area, where there are a number of tools available for you to use: COSHH forms, a search engine, chemicals and biological agents, and groups and sections. These tools are also available on the toolbar at the top of the page. The help section shows you a number of pages where you can access help for filling out your COSHH form. For instance, section 1 demonstrates how to complete the form in the same way as this presentation will. Now we want to create a new COSHH form by clicking on one of the tools in the members area. You can either create a COSHH form by clicking on this box here, or in our case we will use a demo COSHH form which has already been set up for the purposes of this presentation. It will take you to section 1 of the COSHH form. You will see the little blue icons. If you click on them, you will get a drop-down help section, and these are throughout the COSHH form and will be able to assist you in completing your form. Once you've completed the title, you want to enter the location where you're carrying out the work. A helpful hint is to put in the number of the room that you're using first rather than the building. It gives you a much shorter list to work with. If you've added the wrong room number, then you can hit the trash can to delete it. Complete the brief description of your work, and in this free text field you can change the format of the text before moving on to the person responsible for this work. In our case, the person responsible has already been set up as a test PI, which I will change. When you enter the name or the initials of the person's name, you can click on the plus icon to add them to your form. Remember to save as well. If you save and you haven't completed all the sections, then it will return you to where you started and highlight in red the places that have not been completed accurately. So in this case, I put in a test PI, save to move on to section 2. In section 2, enter the hazardous substances that you're working with. Put in the name of the substance into the search field and click on the plus sign to add them to your selected hazardous substances. You then complete the quantity and the form of the substance that you're working with. Another example, hydrochloric acid, enter the beginning of the name. You can also click on the little triangle and it will give you a drop-down list of the hazardous properties of this particular substance. Once you've completed your list of substances, you will go on to complete the free text field for quantity and the form of the substance for each of the substances that you've added to your list. You will then scroll down to section 2.2, routes by which substances are hazardous. You will then enter the route of entry for each substance you have added to your COSHH form. Section 2.3, Process Factors. Here you want to check the process factors you are using as part of your work activity. If you need to, use the free field text to include any other process factors which are maybe not included in this list. Section 2.4, again, comments on the hazards associated with the substances, and you can use the formatting tools on the toolbar if you need to. Don't forget to save before moving on to the next section. In section 3, we'll be looking at the individual groups that may be exposed as part of your work activity or your process. Either those groups who are at risk of exposure from your work activity, or those individuals who may be more susceptible to the types of substances that you're working with. Identify how you're going to notify people in the work area about your substances before saving and moving on to section 4. Section 4 deals with the risk control measures. In the first instance, can you eliminate or substitute any of the substances you're working with? Either select yes or no. If you select no, then please, if you can, put in an explanation into the free field text box. ...4.2 deals with engineering and design control measures, generally local exhaust ventilation, microbiological safety cabinets and so on. Fill in all the fields that are necessary for this part of the form. In the case of microbiological safety cabinets, you could select either 1, 2 or 3, depending on the class of the cabinet. It is also useful to include the biological laboratory containment level 1, 2 or 3 when working with biological agents. Administrative controls enter the type of admin controls you're using as part of your COSHH assessment, any information relating to instruction and training that will be provided prior to any work to be carried out, supervision and lone working. Can the work be done unsupervised? Does it need a written system of work? Where lone working is allowed, then ensure that a risk assessment is in place and include the reference number where possible. Moving on to section 4.6, this covers the personal protective equipment necessary for the work you're doing. Again, complete the fields which are most relevant, putting in as much information as you have available. Section 4.7 deals with monitoring and health surveillance. Again, complete the sections as required, both for monitoring and health surveillance. Again, save before moving on to Section 5. Section 5 deals with risk evaluation rating, which is fully explained in the Principles and Practice of Risk Assessment training course. Complete the fields as necessary before saving and moving on to Section 6. Section 6 deals with the storage, transport, handling and use of the substances that you're working with. Again, a free field text to give details of how this will be managed. As you will see on the bottom line, there are boxes with numbers which detail the different types of sections that you are in. White for those that you have completed, blue that you're working on, and orange for those that you have still to complete. Section 7 deals with waste disposal routes, and you need to tick the ones that are relevant to your work activity before saving and moving on to Section 8. Use the free field text if necessary. Again, save before moving on to Section 8. This deals with spillage emergency procedures. Again, check the ones that are relevant and complete the free field text with any additional information relating to spillage or emergency procedures. Again, always remember to save before moving on. Section 9, substances activities subject to other legislation. In the main, you will tick risk assessments, but there may be other legislation that is relevant to your work. Again, save before moving on to Section 10. This is where you will put a summary of the assessment recommendations into the free field text. Use the formatting tools in the toolbar within the free field text. Save before moving on to Section 11. In Section 11, you can choose whether or not to put a safe method of working in. If you do, then you must complete the free field text in the box below. Attach files by clicking on Attach Files, choose the file, select the file that you want to attach to your COSHH assessment, in this case a safety data sheet, open and upload file to server. You can then click on View Files, and in this case we now have two files. If you don't need one of them, then you can delete it before closing. Save before moving on to Section 12. In Section 12, there are a number of things that you can do. You can add users to your COSHH assessment. In this case, I'm going to add a test DSC. And a test PI. If you want to remove them from the COSHH form, click on the trash can to delete them. Another feature of Section 12 is that you can add class lists to your COSHH assessment. If you enter the class code into the text box, then click on the plus sign, it will add all the members of that class. In this case, we've only got two individuals. This little icon allows you to sort the list into alphabetical order. If you don't want the individuals, hit the trash can. I'm going to add a test PI. And a test user, that so that I can show you another feature later on. If you're happy with your COSHH assessment, then and you're ready to save and request approval, then click on the Save and Request Approval. This will send your COSHH form to your responsible person so that they can approve your COSHH form. Once you're done, click on Done, and it'll return you to your home page.